Do you want to know how you can finally get rid of eczema in your everyday life? I used to struggle with eczema for a long time, and it wasn't until much later that I realized a lot of eczema is caused by your lifestyle. Some of the things I was doing were mistakes, and they were the reason my eczema kept coming back. So I changed things, and that's when I saw the change on my skin. If you're interested in doing this too, let me tell you what I changed, and maybe it can help you too. And when you have eczema, you probably know that if you don't stop the itchiness, your eczema has a hard time healing because you're always scratching and taking skin off. So stopping the itchiness is a really important first step. I find that if I can stop the itch in the very beginning when my eczema is still small, then my skin gets better faster. So something I do these days, every day, I will use a moisturizer on my skin and adding in a moisturizing routine. And not just any moisturizer. If you have eczema, you want to get the ones that have ingredients specifically for taking away the eczema itch. The kinds I like to use are moisturizers that have colloidal oatmeal or honey in them. Colloidal oatmeal and honey are two natural anti-inflammatory, anti-itch ingredients. They have been used for centuries to treat skin issues, and I find that when I use these, my skin feels less itchy and my eczema is less likely to flare up. So using a moisturizer like this is the first thing that can really help. Okay, this next thing I started doing, I used to get weeping eczema, or those little red bumps that tend to get wet. I would actually get this a lot on my legs and my arms. If you've ever had these type of flare-ups, you probably know that they tend to spread quite fast. I used to just leave these kinds of flare-ups exposed, but when I read about this, I saw that this type of eczema tends to get worse when it's rubbed or if it's exposed to outside irritants like bacteria or dust or things outside. If those things touch the place where your skin is wet or open, it can get in the way of your eczema healing or make the area worse. Nowadays, as soon as I get one, even a small one, I cover it up right away. This is the first thing I do, and it really helps to protect it from those outside things that can irritate it. I find that if I cover it up before I go about my day, it makes a huge difference, and my eczema will actually look better at the end of the day. If you want to do this too, you'll probably notice that your eczema goes away much faster. And speaking of protecting your skin, did you ever get those rough eczema patches that are dry and then they get itchy no matter how much cream you use? I used to get these on my hands and on my neck, and I used to think that these kinds of breakouts were random, but it turns out that this type of eczema is actually really common when you come into contact with something harsh outside. That harsh thing can make your skin break out in dermatitis or eczema. So what things outside can you avoid to heal this type of eczema? Well, one big one I discovered for myself was in a lot of the things I was using. It's artificial fragrance. Artificial fragrance is a chemical that is one of the biggest skin triggers. In fact, it's so commonly linked to eczema that it's actually classified as a top skin allergen because it can create flare-ups with people who never even had skin problems before. I used to wear a lot of perfume, and I think all of my skin products had fragrance in them. After realizing this, I started to wear less fragrance on my skin every day, and it has really helped. Nowadays, most of the things in my house are fragrance-free or only have natural fragrance, and I noticed that my skin doesn't break out in those rough patches anymore. If you also get this, definitely look into your products and things around you. If you see the words artificial fragrance on things you use on your skin, try to avoid it or switch to natural fragrances. It can really help those rough patches to go away. And as we talk about what to use on your skin, this is something we don't often think about, but maybe you have tried all these things and you find that your eczema still comes back. Did this ever happen to you? Like you are super careful about your skin, but you still have breakouts? A lot of people don't realize this, but using natural products or moisturizing more often, these are the obvious things to do. But if you really want the most results, you also have to look inside. For me, the biggest change in my life, where I went from eczema every day to clear skin every day, That happened in a couple of weeks when I started to change some of the things that I was eating. There are some foods that when you eat them can trigger inflammation in your body, and that can affect your eczema later on. If you think about it, we eat every day, almost all the time. And that's why food is such a big trigger for people with eczema. It's one of the biggest things that you are exposing your body to. If you haven't looked into food yet, you are really missing out, because a lot of people can get great results just by changing what they eat. If you want a good starting place on this, I actually talk more about this in my free video series called The Clear Skin Plan. Over there, I show you how to get rid of eczema from the outside and within. I'll leave a link for you below. A lot of people who join get results with their skin in real life. Doing these things really changed my day. My sleep improved at night. I felt much more calmer and more confident in myself. If you're interested in doing this too, it can really help your skin to feel better on a regular basis. And now that you made it here, I want to know, did this video help you know what to do for your eczema? Leave me a comment below. I love hearing from you. If you don't know where to start, come join the plan. There's a link in my description box below. Go click it. You don't want to miss out. I'm Christina, and I'll see you in the next videos. Bye.